Hello friends, it's been a long time since I made a video on the development progress we have made. It has been a tough time for everyone out there with the lockdowns and the personal and financial losses due to COVID. Fortunately, the world is coming out of it and the vaccine is here. But the impact of the lockdown is still hitting the businesses. Things are going very slow for us too, since most of the clients we have are in UK and Europe. Businesses in India, even though have started operating, are still impacted by the manpower shortage. Orders are getting delayed by weeks. Even parcels coming in from outside are taking too long to clear from customs. Maybe it's because of the sudden workload which has increased for them. During lockdown, we made some progress on the designs which we had planned earlier. It was a good time to focus on the new designs. After the VALTRACK-V4-VTS vehicle tracking device was released, there had been a lot of demand for a small tracker like the V2MF, but with 4G capabilities. It can be for LTE or for NBIOT. So we set out to design this new device, small in size, like V2MF. But the smallest LTE module we could find was the SIM7600G, which is a 30mm by 30mm size. And as you can see, the board dimensions has been based on the size of SIM7600G. This is the same model that has been used in the VALTRACK-V4-VTS device. And the GPS or the GNSS module which we have used is the SE868 module. And it's used because I am yet to find a GNSS device that has inbuilt antenna and is as small as this one. As you can see here, all parts have been placed on top side of the PCB and the SIM7600G sits on the other side of the PCB. There were a few design challenges we had to face. The GNSS modules have a recommended mandatory ground plane size mentioned in the data sheets by the manufacturer. If we go by that, then we can never be able to design these small tiny devices. We have to compromise on performance a bit by reducing the ground plane. The manufacturer knows this very well, so they also recommend that if we cannot provide that big of a ground plane, then we need to place the module in the corner of the PCB. That's what we did here. We placed the module in the corner. This gives very good acceptable results. The design is essentially the concentrated shrunken version of V4MFWB, which I had shown in my previous video. So this is the V4MFWB. It had wireless charging and also comes with Bluetooth 5 chipset. This was designed to fit into a ready-made enclosure. That's why it was designed in this shape. And the size is also quite big. But V4MF, on the other hand here, will have to fit in small places. So it is specially designed for installation in hidden places. So the V4MF will usually fit in hidden places, may it be another gadget that needs to be tracked, like a laptop or any expensive instrument. It can be fit into shoes, to track kids, or even someone can design or build their own enclosure and product around this. The possibilities are endless. To give you some examples, I had got the requirements to design the V4MF for fitting into an indicator light or brake lights of bicycles. Europeans use very expensive bikes and they often get stolen. In India, the bikes are very cheap and no one cares or bothers to steal them. Now that we know the background and genesis of V4MF during lockdown, let's talk about some specifications. V4MF is 30mm by 30mm in size and uses a 4-layer PCB. It runs out of a 3.7 volt to 4.2 volt LiPo battery. You can use lithium ion as well. V4MF has support for key wireless charging through this 10 microhenry inductor given here. It works great. I had got them custom made for my tiny designs and I have a lot of them in stock. You can see the key charger is able to detect the V4MF. V4MF supports nano SIM cards using this push-pull type connector provided here. There is a 3-axis MMA8652 accelerometer provided here for power saving or no moment. Debugging and firmware loading is possible using this 10-pin flex connector, which has SWD lines routed to it, so as to program the STM32WB55CU6MCU. The MCU has the 256 KB of flash memory and supports Bluetooth 5.0. We can use this Bluetooth to load the firmware onto it wirelessly by using an Android app. That's how I am able to support my customers now for V4 VTS also, and it has been a great help and relief because customers reports the fixes they need, and we release the binary files which they update themselves at their place itself. Loading firmware for V4MF by this flex connector, you will also need a 10-pin adapter board which is available on the store. You can order it in case if you want to experiment with the boards by writing your own firmware. And of course, you will also need a JTAG like ST-Link or J-Link to load the firmware. 128 KB or 1 megabit EEPROM is provided here. It is made by ST and it comes in a TSSOP package. This is used for storing the parameters and also for storing the lost pings due to network problems. And those will get re-forwarded again when the signal becomes available. Again, two power MOSFETs have been provided here for controlling power gating to the Genesis module and the cellular module for power savings whenever we need them. Three numbers of Rgb LEDs are provided to indicate different conditions of battery status, network status, and Genesis status respectively. I will make a separate video on the indicators explaining what each indicator means with what color and the blinking rates. We are also working on the documentation in parallel, which will be made available soon. The coil is directly soldered on the SMT pads. I have made multiple wires on the pads to make them strong to prevent rip-off on movement. Battery connectors are two through-hole pads which are strong enough to hold the wires. Now let me show you the other side of the PCB. As you can notice, there is a difference between both the PCBs because there are two variants I made. The first one was the VALTRACK-V4-MF, the LTE version. So this is the first version we made, which has the standard SIM7600G module. The other one is the VALTRACK-V4-MF NBM1, which means it supports NBIOT and CAT-M1 networks. The NBIOT module is smaller, and we have some space left on this side of the PCB, which I have used for providing some test points. Another bonus point is that once we designed the NBM1 version of V4MF, Simcom launched a footprint compatible LTE module in 24mm by 24mm size, which directly works on the NBM1 version. Isn't that great? So this is the LTE module which Simcom has launched recently. This is called the A7670 series. This module is in the same size of the SIM7070G 24mm footprint, and it directly works on this design as well. So if I put the 7670 on this one, it will directly work, and this same board will support the LTE networks. The advantage of these modules is that they are very cheap compared to the 7600 series, and they are smaller too. There is a large price difference between both of them, but unfortunately, the A7670 series is only available for Europe and Asian bands. There is no band for America and Australia, so we have to use these modules only for Europe and Indian markets. So, in case if you are ordering from US, you have to order the 7600G version itself. This one will support all the network bands anywhere in the world. So let me connect and show you how this board works. We're using this JST XH connector, which is by default available on the batteries. So you can easily plug in the battery. And you can see the device has turned on, and the lights which you can see here. The first light, the green one, is the battery indicator. It indicates the battery status. It will give you some voltage indications. Whether the battery is less than 3.7 volts, it will be red color. If it's between 3.7 to 3.9, then it will be blue. And if it's above 4 volts or above, then it will be green. Now the battery is fully charged. That's why you are seeing this green color. The middle one is the network indicator. So as you can see, it turned green now, indicating that the network is available and it has been, and the SIM card has registered to the network. The last LED is the GPS or the location LED. It will indicate whether the location fix has been achieved. It's going to be red now because I'm indoors and you won't get the GPS location fix here. Now let me keep this on the charger and see what happened. Now as you can see, the battery LED has started blinking. This indicates that the battery is charging now. So the blinking will indicate that the battery is charging. If the LED is stable, it indicates that the battery is not charging. I'll post a few more videos on this board with live working demos in different applications. Till then, see you, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.